Hello and welcome to another quick look into a game. This time, however, we are not doing a preview and looking in a game which is going to be released, but we're looking into a game which will unfortunately never be released, because this game, Buck, is basically abandoned. And the developer went bankrupt and founded a new company. But let's go through that step by step. So the full title of the game is Buck, a Saturday Morning a Cartoon Apocalypse. And it's a 2D side-scroller, platformer, brawler type of game. We are currently in a town, so we are not getting attacked by anyone, but we will also see combat. And in this video, I will show you a bit of the history and then just basically maybe an hour or so of gameplay. And I did this already before. I did a jump version of this video basically, so I am a bit familiar with the start of the game. But before we go into that, we will take a look at the history, and for that I need to swap over, and unfortunately also the music is away then. So we are taking a look at the Kickstarter project first. So you can see that, not a whole lot of money was gathered for this title, $31,000. The goal was 30,000, but that's really not a lot to make a game. So there were a couple of people working on that. You can see that I pledged $10 myself. And that was also kind of the reason why I did that, because it was cheap. And I mean, the game, the art style was looking nice. I'm personally not really a brawler fan. And the only experience with brawlers I have are basically back in the days with the Commodore 64 with Double Dragon and the Turtles game, and then on the Game Boy with some karate games, but that's pretty much it. And this Kickstarter project was funded in 2016. Then on 2017, the game was released as early access version on Steam. And this is a bit more critical, because with Kickstarter, I would say, okay, I pledged $10. I really don't know if the game will finish or not. And that's basically a bet, right? But if I buy a game on early access on Steam, I guess I have the expectation that the game will also release. But that's maybe not true. And I mean, we can see that with a couple of games. And one of them, for example, is also a game from Double Fine. I mean, it has been released, but Double Fine is also a big company, or not a big company, but a big name. It's an indie developer, but basically consisting of the ex-LucasArts people. And they also had this huge Kickstarter success with the Double Fine adventure. And they made a game called Deep Space Base DF9 on Kickstarter, on Steam Early Access, and they saw, okay, not enough people are playing it, so we're basically abandoning it. I mean, they finished the game more or less, that you can play it and that it didn't crash, and then they plopped the release seal on it, and then it was officially released, but it had no content, so it was still not really a game worth playing, I would say. And this game didn't even reach this status, and it was decided in 2020 already, in October, that it will be removed from Steam in 2021. This is a snippet from Facebook, from the developer channel. So yeah, it's completely removed from Steam. I mean, you can still see it here, but you cannot buy it. And of course, I can also still play it, because I've got it in my library. And so, I mean, it's a good thing that you cannot buy it anymore, but still. It's also kind of funny that it got the Indie Prize for best art and best audio, and the audio is, we will see about that, but in my opinion it's not really great. Okay, so that's the background of the game. So 2021, in January I think it was removed from Steam, and that's pretty much the end of it. So this company which made the game was Wave Interactive, and they basically went bankrupt and refounded the company as Orca Studio, and they're now making some free-to-play, I think it's a PvP game, where you Bonto Build, it's the name. You can have a look, but I mean, that's just even making it worse, kind of. Abandoning the one game to create another one, but I guess this one is basically under the umbrella of a bankruptcy, so I'm not sure what the legal situation is in that regard. So we will switch back to the game, and now I need to also switch OBS to this, and I hope that the picture is coming back any second now. Yeah. So, we will start a new game. First, we will go to the main menu. First, I will make a shortcut here. Alright, so, this is our options menu. And here we can, in theory, change stuff. But in reality, we can't. Because no matter what we change, for example, we can reduce the music volume. And it doesn't do anything. So, that's not working. We also have key bindings, which we cannot change either. So at least we can see what keys we can use. And we've got the controller scheme, if you're playing with controller. I didn't try that one though. I also have no idea with the key bindings what's alpha 1 and alpha 2. So no idea how to reload my weapons. But it's not really necessary for the first hours anyways. And now we will start a new game. Launching a new game, we reset any previous games. Yeah, because this game basically uses an autosave. You only have one save game, and you can either play through the save game, or if you leave the game, you will automatically resume at the latest checkpoint. So we create a new game and go into the intro. Yes. Up and
she's not worth it, Bucky. Just forget about her and get a good night's rest. I'm not leaving because of Jody. Then why? Don't sit there and pretend like you don't already know. I was trying to protect you from them. Is lying the only thing you know how to do? Son, I... That was the last time I saw him. I just pray that for once in my life, history will not repeat itself.
Yeah, and that's what I mean with voice acting. It's too artificially changed, dramatized, and then the emotions in the voice are not really there.
I failed him. He was completely alone, all over again.
Yeah, it's like, I failed him, completely alone. I mean, if I was talking like that, you would also not take me serious. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think the voice acting is really great. We also have a few other characters, or, well, at least one other character, and it's also a very weird voice there. I mean, you have to see that it's also not the a AAA game, but it's just a bit weird that they got, like, well, nominated. I don't know what this means in this context, but... For the audio. I mean, the sound effects and so on, they are nice for the most part. There's just one thing or two things, I think. Like, for example, the rain, which is fine at the moment. But there's also sometimes a loop where it just breaks in between. I mean, this, of course, is also work in progress, as you see in the bottom right. Obviously, because the game didn't release. But, so... Everything you see with game mechanics, of course, it might have changed if the game ever released. For the voice acting and so on, I don't think so. Regarding the combat, well, I will first go to the next one. So we have the WD, you can see on the top, like there are two slots for weapons. And you can also see that I'm not using any of them. Well, the first one is empty, the second one is a shotgun, right? And for now I'm pressing A instead, because that's normal kicks or punches. And you can also go into the tips and combos overview here. And in here you can see the like that you can, in theory, do some attack combinations. So for example, if you attack three times and then do an up kick or up punch kick, whatever, you do a roundhouse kick. If you go down, you do an uppercut, and you if you go right, you do a gut kick. It's a bit weird though, because if I go to the right, so if you remember, punching three times triggers that, right? If I go right, that works. So it's three times. If I press the button down, so you can press right and then just hit three times and it will use the combo. You don't need to wait for going right until the combo triggers. But if I go down and do the punch, he does an uppercut right away. You don't need to hit three times. You can, but you don't need to. For the roundhouse, however, you need to hit three times. And there was a third one, right? Uppercut. No, that's... Yeah, roundhouse kick, uppercut, gut kick. These are the three ones. I never use the other two because this basic attack is good enough.
Freezing out there. Not that he'll admit it. The fire stank of rotten meat and gasoline.
Take all. We also have a tiny inventory. If I press tab, I can open the inventory. You can see like 10 items in here. You can eat them, for example, if you have something to eat, which will increase your hit points again. You can take a look into the journal. And we actually have quests in here. And we can also move around on the world map. We cannot move freely around, but as soon as we leave a zone, we can choose our next target. But it's very, well, as far as I played it in the first hour or so, it's rather linear, so that it doesn't make much of a difference. But you can revisit old zones where you will also have respawn at that point. We can also, oops, I wanted to throw that away. With drag and drop, which is a bit weird now here, you can throw something to the floor. This is not a button. You don't do anything by clicking there. But you can drop something by dragging it there. And then, for example, I can take it again. And now we move on to the next enemies. Shotgun. Yeah, let's try the shotgun. Bam. It's also a bit unfortunate that you cannot jump and kick or something. That's usually what I like most, since I played like the first Brawlers or also beat 'em ups like International Karate Plus, where I was just jumping around all the time. Now we've got two enemies, and the trick is to always keep them in front of you and together, and that way you will hit both at the same time.
The guard was dead.
Now we will reach the city, basically.
Stop! Who are you? How did you get in here?
Yeah, well, your front gate is open.
What? How is that possible? Did the guard let you in?
I'm afraid your guard is dead, but the two bad-smelling scumbags who did it are now in the ground.
Damn these vultures. It was bound to happen again. Poor Rusty. Nevertheless, you need to leave this base immediately.
I think her voice acting is a little bit better, but in there you can hear the like the microphone. If you like, if I do this, it's this popping noise. You have that with her piece. You can hear that. So also not ideal, or at least not super professional. I'm not from around here. I need help.
Look, I ain't from around here. West Town is the only lead that I have. I'm trying to find someone who's gone missing.
Never turn down a new mongrel, Zoe.
A what?
Look, there's no time. I have to go and replace Rusty. Mug, Zoe here. I'm sending a new recruit down your way. Over.
What are you doing?
What's your name?
Buck.
Listen, Buck. No one enters West Town without giving something in return.
I just wanted to ask about the girl. I didn't plan on staying.
It's a fair trade, Buck. Don't like it? I can just kick your ass out of the gate.
Jeez. All right, fine.
Now, go inside the pub and talk to Monk. He's our captain. Convince him that you can be useful. Otherwise, I can't guarantee your safety.
Boom, boom, boom. She said her name is Jody. Talk to Monk, the leader of West Town.
What are you waiting for? Go talk to Monk already.
We will do that. To the Boneyard. Yeah, well, the graphics style, I think, is...
The smell.
It's nice. It's somewhat unique. I mean, maybe you know Cly, which is a bit going into that direction. They did this, what's it called, some ninja game. Also, Don't Starve is from Cly, if I don't, I'm not mistaken. And Invisible Ink, not sure, but yeah.
So.
Yeah, it's also wieder, it's also overacted a bit with the overacted and not acted at all, some weird combination with the voice. I'm also here to find someone.
I'm also here to find someone.
You're through into my town. I'm from head to tail. If you came here looking for trouble, you'd be surprised to find out how many guns are pointed at you at this very moment.
Not looking for trouble. I'd say it was worth the foresight.
I just killed two bandits who took out your guard. I'd say it was worth the foresight.
Zoe has failed to mention that. I see what's going on. She's doing you a favor, ain't she? Oh, that lass would be the death of me. All right, that's enough of that. Let's get down to brass tacks. Wiston welcomes only those who protect her. Prove you can be trusted, and we'll take it from there. You'll go to the ruins of Old Town, east of here. Clear out any vulture scum you come across. Gather whatever supplies you can find out there. And find out what happened to our scouts, who never returned. Dismissed.
Okay, so we'll find out about the scouts which never returned. Yeah, sometimes with the, like, if I'm right in front of him, I can't talk to him. It's a bit... okay.
Broken or not, if it works, you keep it. That is the way of things here in the desert.
And now...
The boneyard looked more like a bunker rather than a pub.
Now we'll go back, and then we will travel. I think I need to bend back my microphone a bit. Then we will travel to the other zone and fight a bit more. To Old Town.
It took tremendous effort to build Old Town. Breaks my heart to see how little remains.
Loot. So we've got scrap, and I think scrap is more or less the currency, but you need that to craft stuff. We will go to crafting in a bit. So I'm not sure if there are actually vendors at some point where you can buy stuff with scrap, but you can definitely craft something with it. Or you were supposed to. So never have one left and one right from you. Some ammo, some stuff, and we will soon run out of space, yeah. So we will take, we will use up some stuff here, the rations, and we take this as well. You can see that the hit points are increasing now. If you switch the zone while it's healing, you will lose what the rest, which would have been healed. And there we all got. That's the second sound effect I had in mind in the beginning, because this laughter from the hyenas is not really great. There. Jump! Still laughing when they're on the floor. And some more ammo, but we don't have any space for that. So we will use this thing and then take the ammo. Not that we will really use that. And now I'm dead. So it's pretty quick if you do the wrong thing, and you shouldn't do the wrong thing then. I mean, okay. And take this. Yeah, just keep them on the one side and keep kicking them down. More loot and some steak to eat, but inventory is full. I'm not sure if jumping actually does anything, because we could probably just move past them.
I can't even begin to explain.
Okay, so here's the bag we need for the mission. We've gone to the inventory because we don't have any space left. Eat some stuff, take the bag. Dum dum tch. Supply and demand, return to Muck in Westtown. So now we need to wait until we are healed up and let's leave the zone again. But before we go to Westtown, we go to...
Old Town is more than a nickname. This town was built to symbolize something. A return to the good old days.
Yeah. Oh, we actually have a crafting bench over here, so I can already show. Like, we can craft some shotgun shells here if we wanted to, which we don't. Okay. We could... It's a bit unfortunate that the inventory is really that small, so we can't do anything. Yeah, we would need to throw something away, which of course we could. I think the wood is actually important for crafting pretty much everything. Like, this raisin needs wood. So we could use up... it's also of no use to just throw something on the board. On the ground, because as soon as you leave the area and return, it's gone. Yeah, so the combat could be really more interesting. If you look at the like Steam updates and so on, they also showed combat 0 and 2-0 and it looks kind of, really cool if they're doing some moves with the shotgun and so on, or no, with the pistol. I think it was the pistol with the akimbo that you shoot left and right at the same time, which you can see if you go to the tips and combos again. And yeah, you can't really see it, but 1, 2, 3 launcher. So you have more sophisticated moves here. Like with a shotgun, you can down, A, forward, up, shoot, and so on, the roundhouse finisher. This is a melee weapon, which is super slow, and you can even combine that with a shotgun. And so you can make it a bit more interesting, but I never felt that it's necessary so far. Also, this one, for example, he will also always hit in one direction. I think I can also just move past him without jumping, makes no difference. So I just moved past, hit 2 times, and this was of course wrong. With a pistol I could just shoot him, with the shotgun he will, I'm not sure if he's actually... No, he actually gets the damage, so... Let's kill him with the shotgun. Scrap! And... Let's use this one. Ah, actually, I am not allowed to leave the zone then. Because now I need to wait! And now you can hear what I meant with the rain. There's a very, very short loop and you can hear a clear break between the loops. So it's going... And break, and then it goes, restarts. And break. And break. And that's a bit annoying. Wood. Timber. That's also a bit annoying if you're finding like these crates and enemies are attacking. Of course, you are in the menu here. So if you're then trying to take everything, you need to to find the button to get out. But at that point, you already have probably received some beating. You can also see below my hit points that there's a bar for my stamina, and when you're doing punches, you are also, when you're jumping, you're losing stamina, and then it refreshes again. So we can't use that, but that's also some crafting item, a vulture's badge crafting material. But unfortunately, the inventory is so tiny that I can't really take it. I could just drop the shotgun shells. Actually, I can reload. That's the pistol rounds. Let's drop the shotgun shells. I did want this. Yeah, okay. More shotgun shells. Bad doggy. What's that? Something edible. Ah! So there I made the mistake of running past. And then you should basically, as soon as you see that someone is running towards you, you should stop and then just hit your punch button. All the same item. Powder, which we can't take anymore because we probably full with a stack of 12. Maybe the different fur of the hyena means that they're a bit different. I don't know. At least we got to use some items now. Music is cool. And so far, also the graphics are, well, as I mentioned, the style is nice and the surroundings here are also kind of cool. I mean, somewhat simple, but nevertheless nice. This, however, will change with the next zone, unfortunately. Not with this one, though. That's our home.
I can't fault you for being angry. But the path you chose, I cannot follow. And so, I'll leave you with an old gift and an old saying. If you want to change the world, there's no better tool for the job than a gun.
Yeah, now we are at home, and here we can, we could have gone here earlier, but here we can also craft web map upgrades.
It just rains and rains and rains.
So there is a blueprint, ammunition schematic, unlocks new crafting options, pistol rounds, and there's additional barrel, but I think we can't.
There was never any signal on that thing. Not for Buck to remember, at least.
So here is the. We can select slot one and then take the pistols, and for example, the shotguns we can replace with this thing. Well, we could also swap that. And here we are back at crafting, so we could craft some resin or block substance, whatever that might be. We can also switch over to blueprints. We can craft an additional barrel, but you can see that there's tons of materials and we have nothing of that. Like the iron ingot, magnetic surface, whatever. So let's craft some pistol rounds, some resin, and that's it. And now we've got our weapon upgrades. So in theory, if we had anything of that, we could attach it to the weapon, but we don't. And it also says installing and removing weapon mods cost scraps. Press in any weapon mod in your inventory to install it. But yeah, we don't have any, so there's nothing to install. And yeah, I guess that's crafting. Look at the picture.
I think that right there and then, Buck began to worry.
And now we go back to the city. Hello again.
The stranger returns. Report.
Report! Give the supplies, give the supplies. We will give the supplies.
Your scouts managed to pull quite a stash. Here.
I found them all dead inside the hotel. I
found them all dead inside the hotel.
Those damned monsters. I won't lie, laddie. Our beloved West Town is dying. If you could help us defend against the vultures and assist the decent folks of West Sound, we'll assist you in any way we can.
Thank you, Mug.
We mongrels watch each other's backs. I expect you to do the same.
Yeah. As I mentioned, that the voices that don't sound authentic at all.
Before, lad, the vultures will recuperate their losses, as they always do. We can't really push them out. But we can maintain the offensive to remind them what real mongrels are made of.
Maintain the offensive coming soon. That might not be in this preview version yet. about Jody.
Her name is Jody, and she vanished a couple of hours ago, leaving behind nothing but a map, which led me here.
Suspicious behavior. Couldn't you pick up her scent?
In this rain?
I'll think of something. In the meantime, go ahead and get to know the locals.
Anything specific?
Anything specific I can help with?
One of our mechanics, Zach, has reported a problem with the town's generator.
What does mongrels mean?
What does mongrels mean?
It's our legacy and our curse. I'd rather spare you the details. We need not dwell on the past. We cannot afford it anymore.
End dialogue. Okay. So, previously there was some guy standing in the door and we couldn't leave to the right. Now we can. Hello. Quick travel here.
Come on, girl. Just hold on a little longer.
She really sounds like she needs a new carburetor.
No way, man. I changed it last week. Should be just fine. Wait a second. Who are you? I know every mechanic there's to know.
Name's Buck. I cut a deal with Mug, so I'm offering my help to anyone in town.
Finally, another mechanic. This is just awesome. All right, so here's the problem. We've been working our asses off, and our tools are in really bad shape. We need some high-grade tools. I'm talking lost tech. There's only one dude who can get his hands on lost tech. Nibbler the Salvager. If you can find him and convince him to sell you the tools, you'll be helping us. Big time.
Nibbler. All right, got it. Where can I find his shop?
Well, I would go to the junkyard. That's where he gets all of his stuff. So you go to the right and talk to Simon. He'll tell you how to get there. Easily.
Can we talk again?
Help us keep town running, Bucky. Find that slippery nibbler bastard and get us some tools.
The Nibbler. Also nice in the background. The kids playing in the pond. With the paper boat. It's awesome. That doggy also looks nice. Another crafting thing. Hello.
Any chance that you're Simon?
Greetings, stranger.
I'm here on Zach's behalf. He said you can point me towards the junkyard.
What's your business there exactly?
We're gonna look for Nibbler the Salvager.
That would be like finding a sane dog in vulture territory.
Gotta start somewhere.
Alright. I'll mark the location on the map for you.
Thanks.
Just do me a favor, lad. When you come back, or more correctly, if you come back, come talk to me, will you? I gave you the safest directions to the junkyard. Good luck. You'll need it.
And this time we can't go past him. And so we will go to the junkyard. Which is over here. The junkyard.
Junkyard is a long one.
And dangerous.
Paved by lunatics. Scavenging on our discarded achievements.
So we've got wood again, which we can't take into inventory, and that's really a bit annoying with the very small inventory. They should at least have made a storage option in the home so that you can store some stuff there and go out with a fresh inventory and have the crafting stuff stored there, because now we're basically...
The cold, sharp wind stabs through his fur.
He wouldn't even budge.
Basically moving around with everything with a full inventory, and we can't take anything new in our inventory. That's not nice. So yeah, as you could see, we went to the north, not north, we went up and back to the beginning, but on the top. So there's some exploration in here, but you can also see that, like previously I mentioned, that the background is well done, and in this case, not so much. It's quite repetitive in this level. So this is like a big level, and everything is looking the same with these bridges. I mean, it's kind of understandable if you want to stretch the game a bit, and yeah, but still, it's, I mean, it doesn't make it much better. Also, it would have been nice if the combat was a bit more challenging. Loot! Yeah, I could have reached the top thing, but we could also now climb up at some other point.
The dog knows to smell what's crawling down the Black Delta.
Let's try out our pistols in a sec. One second. Actually, I'll show you something else. Then the game freezes for a short moment, and then the enemies are not the most clever ones. So yeah. So now we can go back for more secrets, maybe. Probably find a chest at the other end again. Boop. And there's the chest. And there we could go back to this point, which we couldn't reach before. So yeah, we've got this thing. This is super slow though, and if you're going to use that, you will get hit because it's just too slow to keep the enemies busy. The pistols are nice, but also you have to use them in a specific way. I think using them very quickly is what you need to do. Otherwise, you are getting stuck with animations, I think. Detached from a gas mask. Uh-huh. Crafting material. Yeah, again. You just have too much stuff. Well, I can't take it anyways, so. Or I can't craft anything with it anyways, so. Let's not bother with it.
I never liked the junkyard, but it proved to be very useful. So many machines were discarded over the years for being broken, obsolete. But to the eyes of the mechanic, nothing's ever really broken.
So, with the shooting, what I meant is, so now I stopped shooting after two times, and then you have this animation where he's removing the pistols again. And if I just keep shooting, I will Yeah, the like the frequency is higher. I mean, obviously, but this is like the difference between being hit and not being hit. And also taking out the pistols, as you could see now. You need to get used to it and know when you're using the pistols, how to use them. Not that you really need them at this stage of the game. Maybe later on, I didn't play that far. So far, you don't have any issue at all with just using the punch button. Also, you get tons of heal on the way, so I mean, still have this left. Will not explore that now. I mean, there's lots of stuff here where you can move around. Like discover, but not really, because it's not looking that differently. Ah, now you can also see we were in the healing process, and because we switched the zone, that stopped. But that's probably something which would have been fixed if the game was released. I wanted to open the inventory actually, and use this one.
The acidic air was unbearable. And he was trying not to think about it.
Give me your stuff!
What could these animals be doing here anyway?
So some train wrecks.
Not much left. So many usable parts have been scavenged.
Ouch. Also, you can't move past him now unless you kill him. Everything after the first attack is a risk. Oops. Loot. Crafting. There's some healing. But I mean, if you die, it's also not the end of the world. You're basically just being reset. And well, I can show you now. So now we just go into the combat again. I mean, in this case we actually have to repeat two fights, which is rather unusual. Faster than before. Jo. We could go up the ladder there, but we won't do that for now. But you can see there's a lot more of the same, and the combat isn't really getting more interesting. I mean, you could make it more interesting by trying around with other moves, for example. I mean, we can just do that and tips and combos and use the this, for example. So down, right, right. Down, right, right. Not sure how that's different to just right, right. Down and throwing does this, but this is super slow, and during that time you just get hit, so basically suicide. Yeah, I don't see any point in that. Elevator.
Somebody's been busy down here.
So just to show, using that thing is just too slow. I will try again and use the other attack. I mean, if they are on the floor already, that's fine. And I can just keep them down. But here we can go, so yeah. Yeah, if you combine the two attack styles, you might do better than just you sticking to one of them. This. Maybe start off with the normal punching and then switching to the club. Ah, we can actually build some grip tape. Uh-huh. So we would have the first component for an item. Hello!
Excuse me. Are you Nibbler the Salvager?
That little rat. Please. You're talking to a captain.
Captain of what? The junkyard?
You bloody mongrels. Get lost.
I'm sorry. Is he an actual rat?
So is Nibbler a rat? Actual rat?
Are you an actual imbecile? Leave me be. I have no time for the likes of you.
This is pointless.
New objective, return. So we did all for nothing. for the quest progress. And now we will go back to the city. Actually, we need to talk to someone else. Hello?
Couldn't find Nibbler in the junkyard. Just more vultures and an angry dog. You got any other ideas where I should look for him?
Why, yes, actually. I managed to tune in to the vultures' radio communication. One of them said, the trader was found, heading to Gotlis.
Gotlis?
A dangerous rocky area at the northeast part of Inganza. The vultures are on their way. I'd advise you to get to him before they do.
Yeah, and now we've got a new zone on the map we can travel to. But we will stop at that point. I think it's... yeah. For the north hideout, got this gulch. So yeah, that is where that was the buck, the Saturday morning cartoon apocalypse, and yeah, I still like the style, and it's a bit of something like a different type of game. But all different aesthetics, different atmosphere, I would say. But personally, I'm not that much a fan of a brawler, so maybe I'm also not really the target group, the audience for that game. Maybe you're more into that kind of stuff. if you would have bought this type of game, or this game, if it was released, then let me know in the comments. Would be interesting to see what you think about that, if you have more experience than just some old Commodore 64 games. I never play any console games and stuff like that, so my experience there is rather limited. But I hope I was able to show you this game with its, well, features, or the features which it should have had if it was finished. Like, I can't really judge the crafting that much, because maybe there would be more in the game if I just continued playing. But also with the inventory, for now it's a bit tedious, I would say. You need to find the... I'm not even sure if you can craft that stuff with... like, if you need to have, I think, 4 different items, and if then the last item needs to be crafted from 4 components, then you have to do them in the right order, and even to put your upgrade or so together. So there are definitely things which are not really thought out yet, or maybe I missed something. But these are things which I guess would have been fixed if there had been a release. But yeah, the voice acting is really not... I am not sure if they would have been done... if it would have been better if they just skipped it and just defaulted to text. I'm also playing on a German channel now, Dead H2, which, for example, is just using text and it's doing fine. If it's not too much text to read also, that's of course an advantage of not doing voiceovers. It's also fine. So in any case, I think the voiceovers are not really the greatest. You can also write if you like that, if it's better than not having voiceovers. I always kind of feel like not having them might be better than having bad ones. Maybe that's just a personal preference. So, yeah, anyways, I hope I have you have a good impression about the game, what it should have been. And if you like this kind of content, then you can stick to this channel, subscribe. I would appreciate that. Give me a thumbs up. On this channel, you mostly find a Let's Plays of, like, currently I'm playing a Geneforge 1 Mutagen. But I will also put some more some reviews on this channel where I put a lot of work into them. Now and then I will also do some, like, one-off videos like this, or there was one for some RPG. Unfortunately, I forgot the name. Some, like, magic-like thing. I will link it in the end. And that's it from me for now. Thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye-bye.